Someone out on Gaslight.
A very good drama, and in some manners a thriller, crime story, with Charles Boyer and Ingrid Bergman in the leading roles, and they play excellently. The character of Charles Boyer is in some manner the ultimate lover. He has a seductive manner, he has compliments, the appearance of a gentleman. Perhaps he is a gentleman, only there is a surprise in store. I hesitate because I don't include spoiler alerts, especially since I'm not going into what happens, who kills who, and but in the case of this composer, musician, piano player, we know quite early, we see that there's something wrong, seriously wrong, tragically. So Ingrid Bergman is a singer, and she has in her family a famous opera singer who died. She was killed, and right at the beginning we see that there is a romance between the character of Ingrid Bergman, the singer, and let's say the composer, piano player. And she wants to get away for a few days. She's on the train. On the train we learn the fact that there was a murder in this square in London, and there's an English traveler, a woman, funny, who keeps talking about her interest in this mystery, and how they don't know who killed the poor woman. Very soon we see that in fact the poor woman is the relative of the young attractive Ingrid Bergman. In was it Cuomo, in this station where they arrive, the composer is waiting for the lover. They talk together. "Oh, I only wish that I would live in London," he keeps saying, "in a house, because London is better. Why not Paris? Why not? London is the one where the homeless feel bad, but those who have a home feel best in London." And our heroine says, "Well, you know, with you I can forget about what happened, about my aunt and all the tragedy, and you know what, you'll have your home in a square in London the way you wish." So they get married, they go to this house terminal, and here a web of lies, of psychological torture, of sadistic acts is unfolding, shocking to observe. As they look around, they see a composition, and then a letter. "Give me that," says the composer, and we're already shocked. And there's a wake-up call, I would say, for the audience, for the public, for me in any case. There's something wrong here. Of course, we know from crime stories, we have been told how to identify a criminal, let's say, and this composer is acting with increasing vileness, and as I said, tortures his wife in many ways. His all his efforts are concentrated on making her think she's crazy, projecting this image elsewhere. He brings in a young, attractive maid. She's played by Angela. She will later become a star in her own right. I don't have the name now, but we can see that she has charm and talent. And the composer is doing all sorts of tricks in order to destroy psychologically his spouse. It's evident that he's doing something upstairs, walking around so that the wife imagines there's somebody in the house when there's no one, so she sees ghosts. He gives her a brooch, but at the same time he steals it so that he would be able to sell this theory that she doesn't remember anything. She takes this from here to there, and in 2 minutes she doesn't know where she left one thing or another. Right. At one point, a sort of a small climax, he's pretending he doesn't have his watch. And that's in the middle of a concert. The watch, of course, was stolen by the husband himself. Very good film.